Are you about moving to the Chicago suburbs? Well then, this video is for you. I'm Amy Pearson, I'm a local realtor. I serve downtown Chicago as well as the western suburbs, and I make community information, real estate, driving tours, happenings in the western suburbs. All right, so this video is gonna cover five things to know about moving to the Chicago suburbs that you might not know if you're moving from out of state, moving from Chicago, you might not know these things. All right, so let's get started. So if you think about moving to Chicago suburbs are a very large area that it covers. Kind of broke it down into three categories. We've got the north suburbs, west suburbs, and south suburbs of Chicago. So if you were thinking about maybe, say, living in the western suburbs of Chicago, you would not want to work in the northern Chicago suburbs. It would be a very bad drive commute to work. So I'm just trying to explain, it's a very large area that it all covers. All right, so if you're thinking about moving to suburbs, I'm gonna give you more information about these three categories. All right, so we'll first start off with the northern suburbs. So north of Chicago, the first suburb, if you're just like maybe 3 miles out of Chicago, Glenview might be an option for you. The suburb is technically a village. It offers plenty of charm throughout. It's known for its high-ranking public schools, good entertainment options, and plenty of things to do throughout. This is a northern suburb. Other great northern suburbs that I get many requests about, interest questions, would be Northbrook, Arlington Heights, Long Grove, Evanston. Chicago western suburbs would be due west of Chicago. People move out to Chicago suburbs usually for the top-rated schools. Suburbs are known for their top-rated schools, specifically in the western suburbs. A good choice would be Naperville. The suburb is located in the Illinois Technology and Research Corridor, making it a great choice for those looking in the fields of engineering and technology. It's been known to be a top suburb in the entire country as well. It provides excellent events happening along with great public schools, top-rated public schools in Naperville. A few other great top-rated choices in the western suburbs that people request a lot would be Clarendon Hills, Wheaton, Addison, and Batavia. Next, we're going to do south suburbs, Chicago south suburbs. So this would be south area of Chicago. So many of these great suburbs are located in just south of Chicago. Chicago Heights is one of these choices. It's in a massive industrial corridor. The suburb offers great employment opportunities along with beautiful historic homes and plenty of great schools to consider as well. So some of the top requested or information people want to know for top suburbs of the south suburbs would be Hazelcrest, Homewood, Park Forest, and University Park. So it's a wide range. So those are my three categories to help you determine. Another thing, if you're looking to move to the suburbs and say you have children to register for school, something you might need to know is that if you're looking to register your child for school, you need to make sure that if you're buying a house, that the house is closed before you can technically register your child for public school. So that is something to keep in mind. And Naperville schools usually fall season, school year starts in mid to late August is when the school year starts for Naperville. Another thing about the suburb, especially if you're moving from out of state, the school years here, we do not have year-round schools here in the Midwest. It's just traditional, starts end of August, ends around May time. So our school year in Naperville ends at the end of May for schools here. A great way to research public schools would be go to this website, niche.com. I'll put it below. It's a great resource. It helps you research top-rated schools in the suburbs. Another thing about moving to the suburbs that you may not know is there's lots of great free programming in the parks in the summer. There's free concerts for kids, yoga in the park, movies in the parks, lots of great free activities. I love free things. So go to the public district or the park district site for the town that you're interested in and just check out their events. So you'd be surprised how many events are offered in the suburbs that are free. I love free things. So that's a lot of things that are happening in the suburbs. If you're thinking about moving there, hope you found that interesting. If you're thinking about moving to the area, feel free to reach out. I'd love to help you. I've worked with many people moving from out of state, and I've been helping them find a home in the Chicagoland area. So stick around for my next video. I think you're gonna like it.